feeling he's coming today.
Who is?
Tom Morris.
Check.
Why would Tom Morris come today?
Don't know. I have a feeling.
Checkmate. Damn it.
Now I know I'm getting old.
Don't worry, John. You'll get it next time.
I thought there would even be a next time. He keeps beating me all the time.
No, I've been learning. It's probably him.
Probably is. Hold on. Hello, Tom.
Afternoon, John. May I come in?
Oh, no, go right ahead.
Thank you.
Mr. Morris?
Hello, Herb.
Yeah, Dad, I'm gonna go upstairs and do my work now.
Okay.
Good night, Mr. Morris.
Good night.
Hey, Tom, would you like some tea?
Yes, thank you very much, Julia. Sit. Oh, thank you.
You know, Julia predicted that you were gonna be here today.
Really?
Yeah, I know, weird, isn't it?
Very.
So, what brings you here today?
I just got back from India.
Oh, yeah, that's right, I remember. How was it?
It was nice. It was pretty there.
I've always wanted to go there myself.
You'd better stay here.
Well, what's wrong with it?
Nothing. Nothing. Never mind. Thank you, Julia.
Thank you.
There was something you were telling me the other day. Something about a paw, I believe?
Yes, a monkey's paw.
Oh, yeah. Right. And, what was so special about it?
Well, how do I... It's a bit of what you might call... magic.
Magic? What do you mean by that?
Here, I'll show you. Sorry. Yes, I'm all right. Yes, sorry, where were we?
Magic?
Yes, anyway, the paw had a spell put on it by an old fakir, which, in case you don't know, is a very holy man. Legend has it that he wanted to prove that fate ruled people's lives, and that those who interfered did so to their own grief. He put a spell on it, so that one person could have 3 wishes from it.
So, why don't you have 3 wishes then?
I did make 3 wishes.
And did they come true?
They did.
And what were they for? Can you tell us?
I'd rather not say.
How come?
That bad?
Well, you can't have been the first person to have it.
I wasn't. The first man, he had it, the paw. I don't know what his first 2 wishes were, but his 3rd was for death. That's how I got the paw.
Well, then, why don't you sell it? I mean, you've had your 3 wishes.
I don't know! I had an idea to sell it, but it's caused enough mischief already.
Hold on, Tom, hold on, look.
If you don't want it anymore, I'll be glad to take it off your hands.
I don't know.
Come on. Let me hold it.
Well, I think it's best I leave.
You're leaving so soon?
Yeah, my wife wants me back in time for dinner.
Okay, I'll see you then, Tom.
Yeah. Be careful with that thing, John.
I will.
I'd get rid of it if I were you.
But, I'll take care of it, don't worry. Nothing's gonna happen. I'll be sure of that. God help you.
Hey, Dad, what's that hand thing in the living room?
Oh, it's a paw. A monkey's paw.
What's it for?
Grants wishes.
And have you used it yet?
No.
Well, let's get to it, shall we?
Oh, come on. Herbert, come on. Let's not make this into a big deal.
Found it!
Do we have to see that thing on the table?
Don't worry, Mom. It's just for a sec. Dad, do you know what this means? This means that with the right wish, we could be rich. Maybe even famous. Don't you want to wish for that?
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't really know what to wish for. Yeah, ever since Tom gave me the thing, nothing ever comes up.
Well, then test it or something. I've got it. Why don't you wish for, say, $2,000? That way you can pay off food, bills, and everything.
You know, John, that might actually be a good idea.
Well, why not? I mean, a couple thousand dollars sounds pretty harmless. Alright. I wish for $2,000.
I wonder how the money's gonna come. Maybe your boss will give it to you like a bonus or something? Or maybe I'll win the lottery.
Herbert, will you please stop bothering me with that? You've been bothering me ever since I made the stupid wish. How about if we just let it all be a surprise? How's that?
Alright, fine. Sorry.
Thank you.
Good night, Dad. Let me know when the money's here.
Where's Herbert?
He left early for work.
Work on Saturday?
Yeah, he said he had a few things to take care of beforehand.
Like what?
Dunno, didn't say. You know, I've been thinking about that wish you told me, and what if it doesn't come true?
No, I have a feeling it will.
How do you know? Well, suppose Tom's right about giving misfortune to the owner?
No, I think we'll soon find out. I mean, he can't be right.
Well, I guess, but even if it does come true, how will $2,000 hurt you?
Well, perhaps it'll fall from the sky and land on my head. Yeah, kind of joking out. Look, I don't know how it will come. All I know is that it's going to happen. So, trust me. I'll get it.
Julia, I think you better come here.
Hello, sir. Are you John White?
Yeah.
I'm here on account of your son, Herbert White.
Herbert? Why, has something happened to him?
I'm sorry, but there's been an accident, and your son is in terrible injuries.
But he's not seriously injured or anything, is he?
Oh, don't worry. He's not in pain anymore.
Oh, thank God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
What the hell do you mean by that?
I mean that your son has been in a head-on collision with the truck.
Listen, why don't you go back into the kitchen? I'll handle this.
I'm afraid so. I probably shouldn't be the one to tell you this, but the insurance company asked me to convey their sincere apologies with you and its great loss.
How long has he been dead?
Since about 8:20, I guess.
He's been dead for 2 hours and you haven't even told me?
I'm just following orders. Anyway, in consideration with the loss, they wish to present you with a certain amount of reparation. About $2,000, sir. Again, I'm really sorry about this.
Can't sleep. You're cold. Are you sure you want to be covered up all the way?
It's colder for my son.
Sit yourself.
I need it. Where is it?
It's in the living room.
I can't believe I didn't think about this before. Why didn't I think about it? Why didn't you?
Think of what?
The Pa, we still have 2 wishes left.
No. Come on, Julia. Don't you think one was enough?
We could wish for Herbert back. It would be like he never died at all.
But don't you think you're being a little too...
Don't ask questions. You go get the paw back, and you go get our boy right now!
Good God, Julia, you're insane.
Just go get it!
Look, you're tired, and you don't know what you're saying, alright? Why don't you just go back to bed, and everything will be alright in the morning?
John, I'm fine. I want my boy back.
But are you sure? Because if you want, we can go visit him at the...
Don't even talk like that! Would you just go get it?
But Josie's been dead for about
Go get it now!
Alright! Alright! If it'll make you happy, I'll go get it. All right, I have it.
Now wish.
Look, before I do this, I just
Just wish, damn it.
Okay, all right, I'll wish. I wish our son were alive again.
What was that?
Probably just the wind or something.
It's Herbert. I forgot the cemetery's only a couple miles away.
Wait. What the hell are you gonna do?
It's freezing out there. We have to let our boy in.
That's it, Julie. Don't let him answer the door.
Don't be afraid of our boy. Let me go. Herbert! I'm coming, Herbert! John, help me with this door!
Oh my God!
John! Help me! John!
I wish the second wish would come to me! Stop it! Julia, stop it!